We've been in a period of dramatic change over the past 5 years, particularly in the transaction processing and global transaction banking industry. What do you see as the key trends that have really driven the industry, and what's changing?
Yeah, well, if you look at two of the major trends, it would be the post-crisis environment and then the regulation that has flowed from that. If anything, I actually see those as presenting huge opportunities. What has it done for the transaction services business? I think it's really brought it back into the spotlight. As a business which has a very solid annuity stream of revenue associated with it. So from that respect, it gives the transaction business huge access within the wider banking industry. In terms of our clients, I think a lot of the regulatory pressures are really coming to the fore, and that's been a theme of Sibos this year. But again, I think it presents opportunities. And what we see in dialoguing with our clients at events like this is, out of some of these challenges, working with our partners in the industry and working with our clients, we can actually find some ways of not just adapting to the new regulation, but also generating some extra benefits, both for ourselves and for our clients. So I think those are the two big trends, and that's certainly a theme that's come out again at Sibos this year.
A lot of banks that used to provide transaction processing services are finding that they can't keep up with the investments that are involved. So how is that changing the industry?
Yeah, I think one of the interesting backdrops is that the transaction services business historically was based on this solid foundation of balance and deposit related revenue. And what's become clear in the current rate environment is that a transaction business has to stand on its own 2 feet at a transactional level. So I think what that has done is generated a much broader and much more innovative thinking around how banks position themselves for the future. And I think the clear trend that's emerging is around partnership and collaboration. And those have been buzzwords, if you will, for many years. But I think the crisis, the regulatory pressure, the need to spend so much to just stand still, I think is really driving banks, not just smaller banks, to talk to larger banks such as Bank of America, Merrill Lynch, but also competitors to get together and, within the boundaries of what regulation and compliance will let us do, is figure out how we deliver things together to solve the same problems. I often use the analogy of the airline alliances. If we could somehow find a banking or a transactional analogy for that and build on that to actually leverage the investments that we're all making to reposition the business to be more efficient in the future, I think that's one of the key things that we need to focus on.
Are there any key talking points you're taking away from the Sibos conference?
I think that the key theme I see is open for business. There's a lot of discussion around the regulatory burdens and the constant challenges and the slowdown in the economy. But I think the key message is there is still business to be done. There are a lot of opportunities. And if anything, this period, which could otherwise be quite difficult, is giving us all an opportunity to rebase ourselves and reposition ourselves. So from that point of view, it's presented huge opportunities and definitely open for business.